My name's Annette Brown. I'm a professional trumpeter. I'm based in Sidcup in Kent, which is just outside London, but I'm very proud to say that I'm from beautiful Harrogate in North Yorkshire. My dad used to play tuba in Knaresborough Silver Band, very badly I might add, and he would be the first to admit that, but to keep the band going they decided that they would start to teach band members' children. So myself and my two brothers went down to Knaresborough Band Room. I was age 6 and was given a cornet. So at the tender age of 6 I fell in love with the cornet, and I fell in love with brass banding too. And I'm proud to this day really that I started on third cornet and worked my way up to being principal cornet with Knaresborough Silver Band. I think it's a fantastic grounding for brass players. I mean, some of the music that was played in those bands, and indeed Jewett Youth Band that I went on to play with, Sam Smith's Brewery Band, Harrogate Band. It's just phenomenal, and the training is just second to none, really. So whilst I was at school, I played in every ensemble going. I played in the orchestra, the concert band. I did brass bands out of school. In fact, I was out 5 nights a week playing music, and much to the detriment of my schoolwork. My poor parents kept getting letters sent home for not doing homework. But from there I auditioned and was accepted to go to the Royal College of Music in London. I would have one word of advice for anybody who auditions to music college and doesn't get in. Don't be despondent, don't give up. Use the money you'd have spent to go to college on sourcing out a teacher with whom you would like to study, because you can use that money to go and have private lessons. Invaluable. Whether you'd like to go into classical, jazz, musicals, pop, there are trumpet players out there who can teach specifically one of those genres, or indeed all of them. So, and with the internet and everything, it's so much easier now to source those people who I'm pretty sure would be happy to give lessons. So don't give up and just persevere.
I feel very blessed to be doing the job I do. I've travelled the world, seen some phenomenal places, done some awesome gigs. I've done the main stage at Glastonbury, and I've played to 140,000 people at Wembley. Lots of television work, and it's very exciting and gives great adrenaline, and it's just a huge buzz. Highly recommend it to anyone.
A phenomenal trumpet player on the scene is a lovely, lovely mate of mine, Georgina Jackson. She's an incredible trumpet player and also a brilliant big band singer, very, very talented. And she and I got together and made an album. And all the money that we raised went to the Mount Vernon Cancer Research Centre. And so I feel very blessed to have had, and I'm still having, a successful musical career. It hasn't always been easy. I am over half a century old now. And so there have been occasions when there was one band I was asked to join in particular that had been male-dominated all its life, a very well-known band, in fact, and I was sitting next to a very famous trumpet player who did not like the fact that I was there. But I had two choices. One was to leave and one was to persevere, and eventually I won him over and we became friends. But thankfully things like that don't happen so much now. I have a lot of friends in the music business, much younger than me, and they don't care who's playing, so long as you do the parts and you're a nice person. That's very important as well. A lot of people ask me about how to get on in the West End, and
there are what we call fixers who book bands for the shows. And it's very important that your whole attitude is right for the job, because the fixers can find out quite easily who you are, what you're like, and not fix you. I think for any brass players who would like to go into the business, whatever genre you fancy doing, whether it be, you know, classical, jazz, musicals, big band, brass band, or all of them, listen to every possible style of music that you can. It's all out there. It's so easy to access nowadays. And you can learn to play stylistically from listening to lots of different music. I do have a mildly funny story to share with you and your listeners, Helen. About 25 years ago, I was asked to do a show on television. And to cut a long story short, the producers had wanted an all-female band, but they didn't like me. Basically because I'm a Yorkshire lass and I love my beer and my chips, so I wasn't quite the model size that they were hoping for. I mean, I'm not huge, but anyway, nevertheless, the producers didn't like it, so they tried to find another trumpet player, but unbeknownst to them, the lady who'd written the music was one of my best friends, and she'd written me some really pearly, juicy trumpet parts. And at the time, the producers couldn't find anyone else to play them in time for the show. So they reluctantly invited me back. But when I got into the studio and took my position, they then stood two very beautiful models in front of me, who basically mimed all the lyrics very badly, I hasten to add. Naturally, I was a little bit cheesed off. But during the interval, I went into the bar and met the cameramen, and we got chatting, and I explained my story and what had happened, and the cameramen swung their cameras past the two models, and I was seen quite a lot on the programme. So anyway, funny story, but sad in a way that that's the way people are, you know, female, large, small, thin, fat. It's a shame that things like that happen. For me, I think it's terribly important when somebody phones you to do some work that you're polite, helpful, arrive on time, have all the gear that you need, have your equipment, have a spare music stand in the car if need be. Reputation in this business is huge, and to have a good one will go far. People will often book somebody that's maybe not... You might not be the better player, but if your attitude and commitment is good, the chances are you'll get the gig. I think mental attitude has a huge role to play in music and in the music business. I remember being on tour, and I was sitting on the beach with a phenomenal saxophonist, and we were drinking mojitos and just having a wonderful time. It was our day off. And we got talking about playing and practicing and this, that and the other. And she said to me, I don't really need to practice. I'm pretty good as I am. Which sounds very, you know, big headed, if you like. But she was. She was phenomenal. But I said, but, you know, for all the time you don't practice, there will be somebody who isn't as good as you who will be practicing. And one day that person will be better than you. And we sat in silence for quite a while. And then the next day, she got her sax out and she was practicing and has not stopped since. So for those people who are brilliant, keep at it. And for those people who don't think they are brilliant, keep at it, because you will be. I've had some phenomenal gigs in my time that just even now thinking about them put goosey gogs on the back of my neck. I was doing a gig at Wembley Stadium where there was 140,000 people, and also Glastonbury main stage. But to see that amount of people with their hands in the air all cheering and clapping for you if you've just done a solo is just something else. But there was one time when I was in Denmark, and the brass section were asked to go on stage dancing to Roll Over Beethoven. So in the full swing of things, off we go, dancing across the stage and with our instruments in our hands. But unbeknownst to me,
whilst looking like a loony on the stage, my mouthpiece fell out of my trumpet down a crack in the stage and onto the grass below. Shortly after the lunacy of dancing to Roll Over Beethoven, I had to play Penny Lane, the piccolo trumpet solo. Thankfully, one of the crew had seen my misdemeanour and was on his hands and knees crawling under the stage and found my mouthpiece in time for me to bang out Penny Lane. Wowza, I was sweating. When I was a little girl, when I was about 16, I wanted to join the Yorkshire Imperial Metals brass band, but they wouldn't allow me to. They wouldn't have women. Thankfully, all that's changed now, and I'm very pleased when I go and see concerts to see girls giving it large on whatever instrument they're playing. But what I will say is, keep going. Music is such a wonderful tool. Fills your soul with joy and your heart with joy. And whether you're playing at an amateur level or professionally, enjoy it. Life's too short. Go for it. And if you're offered a show that pays 50 quid, go and do it. I do it all the time because I love playing and I love to see the joy on people's faces when they enjoy what they're hearing. Or at least I hope they enjoy what they're hearing. I think the internet is a wonderful place for us now. Of course, it wasn't around in my day. I had a mobile phone that was the size of a brick. That's how old I am. Anyway, I digress. But get on the internet. Google brass players. Even if you don't know the names, you can just put in female brass players or female saxophonists or female trumpet players or whatever. And also listen to the guys. And in this time of lockdown, if there's something that you're not so good at, tonguing, triple tonguing, double tonguing, range, style, slurring, all sorts of things, YouTube is a wonderful place to look. And for trumpet players, there's a chap that's been doing 100 days of lockdown. His name's Rex Richardson, phenomenal player. Learn. It's all out there. I think from personal experience, the amount of males in the music business who don't want females are becoming a dying breed. I know that sounds a little bit harsh, but I didn't know how else to word it. Because a lot of the work I do these days, it seems I'm the grandma of the band and there's all these phenomenal upcoming musicians, male and female. I feel like I'm the matriarchal elephant. But I would strongly, strongly recommend and encourage parents and teachers to inspire and help and encourage females to be in this business, because it's such a wonderful world to be in. And yeah, you get your male people that are a bit of a pain, but equally you get females that are too. I know some women that are a bit spiky to work with, and to be honest, they don't really get the work. So I think it works both ways, but I would strongly encourage teachers and parents to let their children be free and let the women go out there and play their instruments. So thank you so much for having me, Helen, and if any of your listeners have any questions, perhaps they could forward them to you and I'll do my very best to answer them. But in the meantime, everybody stay safe, look after yourselves, and enjoy the sunshine. Bye for now.